I am Dr. Vivek Gupta, standing here with my senior colleague Dr. S.K. Gupta in Apollo Hospital, New Delhi, 31st of December, last day of 2019. And about 6:15 p.m. we have finished an interesting case, which is otherwise a routine case for many government hospitals. In Apollo Hospital, we do not get too many of rheumatic heart disease patients. And with my team of Mr. Avtar, who is this time doing the recording as nursing staff at 6 p.m. in Apollo Hospital. So Dr. S.K. Gupta will tell us the technical part of this BMV. She's a young 20-year-old female who has a severe critical mitral stenosis with a valve area of 0.8, and she had the commissurotome was slightly fused, but there was no major calcification, and echo showed mild mitral regurgitation. So we discussed with Dr. S.K. Gupta. He agreed that we'll do a suboptimal or BMV in this case without taking much of risk. So this is the technical part which he has shown. Dr. Gupta did the most of the case here. And this is the balloon which was invented and innovated by Dr. Inoue. And we all know this is different from coronary balloon. And Dr. S.K. Gupta made a preparation of this. And can you speak a little, two, three words about this?
Now, this balloon is, it has got a balloon at the tip of the catheter, which needs to be prepared before introducing it to the patient. And the measurement is that we have to measure the patient in height in centimeters. And then from that we calculate which size of the balloon has to be taken. The formula is that whatever is the height of the patient in centimeters, like if this patient had a height of 151 centimeters. So the calculation is that we will use a balloon here of 25 millimeter in diameter. So we choose the catheter accordingly and then did the valvuloplasty. Here there was a little problem when we started. The first time when we punctured the septum, possibly it was a little higher puncture. You see here we punctured the septum, we measured the pressure in the left atrium, and when we tried to negotiate the balloon into the, see, this we were trying to negotiate the balloon into the left ventricle, but it was not going. So that's why we thought that possibly the puncture is high. We took another puncture at a little lower level, and then we did the procedure.
Show the lower level puncture now.
This is at the lower level.
Lower level. Okay.
And when we did this, this time the balloon went very smoothly. This time, now the wire is inside. We are dilating the septum with the dilator. Then we took the balloon, and this is the balloon in the left ventricle, and the balloon is getting inflated. Do you see this? The balloon got completely inflated. The valve has opened up nicely. Thereafter, we have taken a angiogram after finishing the procedure, and this is a good result, very good result of valvuloplasty. The LA pressure from 35 has come down to about 11-12. And there is no mitral regurgitation. Very good result, successful.
Thank you very much, Dr. Gupta. I would just like to summarize finally. This is different from coronary angioplasty. Everybody knows about coronary angioplasty. We have to go from artery. Here we have to go from the groin again, but the femoral vein. From femoral vein, we go to the inferior vena cava, then we go to right atrium, right side of the heart. From the right, we have to do the septal puncture, which he was talking, that we have to go from the right atrium into the left atrium. Because the mitral valve is placed between the left atria and left ventricle, then you have to cross with the balloon from left atria to left ventricle. That is the technical part which is important. The first important critical portion of this procedure is the puncturing from the RA to LA. And second portion is to negotiate the balloon from the left atrium to the left ventricle. So when we were doing this procedure, we noticed that this balloon, after doing a good septal puncture, the balloon from LA to the left ventricle was not being negotiated easily, and therefore he had a very nice idea that perhaps the septum, which is about 3 to 4 centimeter, we have to do another septal puncture, and he did it very nicely because it requires a really lot of effort and skill to do another septal puncture. He did it very quickly, a little lower down, and then we were able to negotiate from left atrium to left ventricle, and in the single balloon opening into the atrium at the site of mitral valve has given a very good result, and without any mitral regurgitation, as evident from the left ventricle angiography which we have done finally. So this is just a small lesson for the people who are doing it, that if you are not able to negotiate from LA to LV, then try to change the position of the puncture site to the left, maybe lower down is better.
Yes.
So Thank you very much for watching this video, Dr. V. Gupta. Myself in Apollo Hospital with Dr. S.K. Gupta and Mr. Aftal, who did the recording, one of the senior most technicians, on the last day of 2019, 6:20 p.m. on 31st December 2019. Thank you very much.
Thank you.